I'm Dr. Frita, and today we're going to be discussing the coronavirus, symptoms, transmission, and treatment. Have you heard of MERS? How about SARS? I know you've heard of the mystery Wuhan pneumonia. Well, what do all of these respiratory illnesses have in common? They are all caused by the coronavirus. Do you know what the coronavirus is? Keep watching. I'm Dr. Frita McCray Fisher, and I'm a physician here in Atlanta at Emory University Hospital Midtown. I completed my double residency in internal medicine and pediatrics at Georgetown University Hospital. Then I completed my nephrology fellowship at Emory. I am a proud graduate of Meharry Medical College, and I have been triple board certified. So now I enjoy sharing my knowledge as a medical expert commentator and a motivational medical speaker. Thank you for watching my channel. What is the coronavirus? The coronavirus gets its name because it has spiky points on its surface, which make it look like a crown or a corona. Coronaviruses are in many different animal species, but we'll focus on the human coronavirus. So there is the common human coronavirus, which can give you symptoms anywhere from mild to moderate, with fever, cough, shortness of breath, kind of like the common cold, and it's usually upper respiratory. People who get the common human coronavirus will typically have short-lived illnesses, maybe 5 to 7 days, and they'll heal on their own and do fine. But then we have the other coronaviruses, the scarier coronaviruses. MERS is one, or Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, and it can cause fever, shortness of breath, but then it can also cause a lower respiratory infection or pneumonia, and MERS is mostly in the Arabian Peninsula. And then there is the infamous SARS. Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome. Now, we first got SARS in 2002, and from 2002 to 2004, even though SARS started off as a pneumonia or respiratory syndrome in Asia, it actually spread worldwide and became a pandemic affecting 37 countries, infecting 8,000 people, and causing 774 deaths. SARS was caused by a coronavirus, but fortunately, there have been no reported cases of SARS since 2004, at least as of January 2020. And now there is what was referred to as the mystery Wuhan pneumonia, which we now know is also caused by a coronavirus. And as of January 2020, we've been referring to this as the 2019 novel or new coronavirus. So some background is that this new coronavirus first had its outbreak in Wuhan, China, and we've traced it back to a live animal and seafood market, which sold seafood, but also sold live snakes, live birds, live rabbits. And initially, 59 people in China were infected at the same time, and it was believed that it was an animal to a human transmission. Even as of the second week in January, we had no confirmed deaths from that pneumonia. We just had the 59 people, and the Chinese government did an excellent job, so it seemed, at really containing people. And as of January 1st, 2020, they even shut down that live animal and seafood market altogether. They decontaminated it, started doing screenings for people who were traveling to and from China, and really being vigilant to try to prevent an outbreak. Well, things changed, and they changed pretty quickly, because there have been cases reported in Japan, the Republic of Korea, Singapore, Thailand, Vietnam, and on January 21st, 2020, the United States of America had its first confirmed case of the 2019 novel coronavirus. We have now grown from those 59 cases to, as of January 23rd, 2020, there are 584 confirmed cases of this new coronavirus. And we have 17 confirmed deaths. And as of January 23rd, 2020, all of the deaths have been in China. The average age of the people who have died is 73. And most of these people have had some underlying health issues, such as diabetes, high blood pressure, or some kind of immunocompromised state. Also, as of January 23rd, 2020, the average age of a person who gets severe symptoms with the infection, 40, and mostly men. And we're not really sure why. So now we have somewhat of a frightening correlation between this novel coronavirus and the coronavirus that caused that SARS with the big pandemic. SARS started off in Asia and then spread worldwide. And now the novel coronavirus started off in Asia and already we're seeing it in different countries. I have a question. How many of you feel very confident that between the CDC, the World Health Organization, that we are going to contain and confine this virus? How many of you feel confident, and how many of you are scared that we could have another huge worldwide pandemic? Please comment down below and let me know your thoughts. So what are some of the signs and symptoms of the coronavirus? Well, with the common human coronaviruses, the signs and symptoms can be mild to moderate, like fever, cough, shortness of breath, runny nose, pretty much signs and symptoms similar to the common cold. But with these other coronaviruses, like the MERS, the SARS, and now the novel coronavirus, you can get mild to moderate signs and symptoms, but then they can also be more severe, like with the outright pneumonia and inflammation. You can get respiratory distress or even respiratory failure requiring hospitalization, supplemental oxygen. And some of the other signs can include chest x-ray findings of these invasive lesions on the lungs. So you may get signs of inflammation, infection, and all kinds of fluid in the air sacs or the alveoli of the lungs. How is the coronavirus transmitted? That is the golden question. Well, with some of these common human coronaviruses, we know that there is human-to-human transmission via respiratory droplets. So how do you get respiratory droplets? If a person who's infected with the coronavirus sneezes or coughs and they get these fine respiratory droplets or particles and you inhale them, you breathe them in, then you have been exposed and you can be infected with the coronavirus. Now, specifically with this novel coronavirus, back when we were calling it the mystery pneumonia or the Wuhan pneumonia, we thought that it was just from animal to human because we had no confirmed cases of human to human transmission. And I'm talking again as late as the second week in January of 2020. We now know that there has been some human to human transmission via respiratory droplets of the novel coronavirus, just like the MERS and the SARS. So again, transmission can be from human to human via respiratory droplets. Someone sneezes or coughs and another person inhales and now they've been infected with the coronavirus. We still have more to learn about the transmission, specifically of this novel or new coronavirus, because if it is very easily transmitted and if it causes severe symptoms in a lot of people, then that can worsen the chances of it being a very serious epidemic or even a pandemic. For example, we know that some viruses are easily transmitted, such as the measles. And if you haven't done so already, please watch my YouTube video on the measles. What is the treatment for the coronavirus? Well, there is no specific treatment, like there's no specific antiviral or antibiotic that will cure the coronavirus. But what we do is we treat the symptoms. If there's a fever, we treat that. Shortness of breath, we treat that. If there's severe respiratory failure, we give supplemental oxygen and we even intubate. What is the incubation period for the coronavirus? Well, the incubation period is believed to be between 2 and 14 days. And right now we're getting this data based off of the MERS, or the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. So once you've been exposed to the coronavirus, it may give you symptoms in 2 days, or it may give you symptoms up to 2 weeks. So how do we prevent the coronavirus? Well, we can prevent it with good hand hygiene, washing the hands with soap and water, cleaning the hands with the alcohol sanitizers, also covering your mouth to prevent the spread of respiratory droplets. You can cover your mouth with your elbow, or if you use a tissue to cover your mouth, throw that tissue away. You also want to be really smart about exposure. Don't go around people who are sick. Don't go to places that you know have been contaminated. And make sure that if you're sick, if you're having fever, cough, or something that could be coronavirus, please don't go to work, don't go to school, don't expose other people. Speaking specifically about the Wuhan pneumonia, or the 2019 novel coronavirus, as of January 2020, we're actually trying to develop a vaccination. And so we are getting the genetics of this novel coronavirus and trying to come up with a vaccine to help to prevent the spread. Now, this is a tricky thing because the vaccine has to, number one, be proven to be effective, and then it has to be proven to be safe. So it's really a race against time, because we also know that these coronaviruses can mutate, they can change, and so it's hard to keep up. But again, the vaccination is another potential way to prevent the spread of coronavirus. Let me ask you this question. If you were told that there was a vaccination developed for the coronavirus, would you take it? Comment down below. I hope you find this video on the coronavirus to be helpful and informative. I always try to do videos for you to live a healthier and happier life. And if you have not done so already, please download this free PDF on 10 healthy habits for a better you and a better life. It's a checklist that I use personally to live my healthiest and happiest life. Make sure you stay informed on the coronavirus, because this is one of those things that is continuously evolving. Make sure you use good hand hygiene, that you cover your mouth, and that you do your best to live your healthiest, happiest life. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel at Dr. Frita, and I'll see you next time.